This training in PowerPoint is to cover how to set color contrast so that your slides are accessible to everyone. I have these two slides here that compare a white color font on a colored background versus a black colored font, and I want to show you that one of them passes the contrast test. I have the color contrast analyzer tool, which is located at this web address. And what I do is I move the tool over and then I check the foreground, which would be the lettering, to the background color. And you see the orange fails. Well, so do all the others here. If I click on gray, yellow, blue, green, and of course the last color here is just a duplicate of this one here. If I move down to the next slide, and you see I have the black lettering, and I use the same tool, and I go to the color of the text and change it to black, each one of these colors will pass. Hey, there's orange, gray, yellow, and blue, and you see they all passed. Now, how do you get these colors? That's an interesting facet of this. So what you would do is you would go to the Design tab, and currently what I have selected right here is the office theme. And I get two variants. I have the white and the black variants. See, if I put my pointer over it, it changes. And notice that there's a second set of colors that show up right here. And there's the color set that I started with the artwork, and then here's the other one. Now, how would I change that? Let's look at that next. So what I would do is let's go back to our white color, and we will then come up here to the drop down for variants, come to colors, and I'm going to come down here to this customize colors. Now the current colors are right here. You'll see that Word is on this orange, PowerPoint is on this yellow, Excel is on this green, and then Outlook is on gray, Stream is on blue, and then the PDF is back on this orange. So if I want to change the color scheme so that the white lettering will pass, I would have to darken up these colors, and it will probably make this black lettering on the orange fail. So let's take a look at that, how I do that. First of all, we're going to call this tutorial set 2, and I'm going to not save it yet until I change the colors. And this is how you would do that. I'm going to click on the orange drop down, go to more colors, and then I'm going to take the slider and slide that down until I get what I think will pass the color contrast test. And so I'm leaving it right here, and you see this is the color it's going to be. And I click OK, and then I'm going to do that for each of these. When you finish doing your settings, you're going to type in the name and then click Save. Now it's all darkened up here, but it's also darkened down here. I could change each of these colors individually, but I'm trying to do this here in the variants of the themes so that it will happen automatically when I'm creating slides or artwork in slides through the Microsoft PowerPoint. So let's go back to our accessibility checker, and let's take a look at the dark letters first. So I have the new color blue, and you see that it failed. And I go to the new color in orange, and it's failed. But now let's go over here to the white lettering and try that test again. Use the dropper and click on the W here, and I get white lettering, and then I see that it has passed, and all these are going to pass most likely. Sometimes I make an error of judgment, and blue, and then the darker green. And so you see that we can change the system so that when we're making slides that the color variation is going to be set to the set that we want so that our contrast is good. And if we want to delete that later, we can come back to colors. And then the tutorial set one, which I've left in here, I want to show you how to delete that or how to edit it. In this case, we're just going to right click on this, and then we're going to go to edit, or as you see, delete. You might be wondering where these effects actually show up, and there are a couple areas. One, as I have mentioned, is inserting the smart art, and the other is inserting a design idea. So if you're on a slide like this one and you go over here to design ideas, you'll see it generates some ideas for you, and you see that these designs are using the color palette that we set up. So for instance, if I change this slide to this one, it's going to take those colors and use them here. And if I were to go and switch any of these colors back to any of these other palettes, you see that they show up in that as well. And another area that you might put a design to is the first slide, the title slide, and you see that it gives me some choices here, and these colors again are coming from the color palette that we set up. And that is why we do some variants, so that we have some colors that are going to be accessible, and we have a tool to check it with, which is the color contrast analyzer. We'll be moving on to some more issues in part 2.